1, 2, 3, 4, I got ice hair. I got ice hair. 1, 2, 3, 4, everybody sing the song of ice hair. 1, 2, 3, 4, I got ice hair. Ice hair. 1, 2, 3, 4, everybody sing the song of ice hair. 1, 2, 3, 4, I got ice hair. Spiky, 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 got some breasts going.
Good day, good evening, good morning, or good night, complete strangers. My name's Dradix. You know what I love?
Video games!
Yeah, but you know what else I love?
The Spider-Man Triple Action Web Blaster!
No! Luigi!
Luigi is awesome! I mean, yes, he was only created so that there could be a second player, and yeah, he really gets the short end of the stick a lot of the time. However, he seems to be the only character in the Mario universe that's at least halfway human.
Look, Luigi! It's a deformed piece of a shit that grew eyes, feet, and teeth! Let's jump on it!
No!
Okay, well, how about we save the princess?
Oh, okay then, how do we do that?
By jumping over a mutant dragon turtle and pulling an axe out of the ground, dropping a bridge while we dodge fireballs the same size as us!
You know, my game sucked the monkey balls, but at least it was set in a world that made sense!
So I like Luigi, and I don't get why people have to paint him as such a coward.
He's got instinct. It's not his fault that he lives in a world where the only way you're able to garner any sort of respect is to be an insane hero.
In fact, you fucking save the princess if ever this stupid world works. Me and Luigi, we're gonna go hang on this island.
So what's up?
Got myself a shaving and now I'm 2 feet tall. What are you gonna do?
Righteous. So yeah, Luigi's Mansion. Let's do this.
So the story goes that Luigi won a contest.
That's my boy.
And was given a free mansion. However, once he shows up, he notices how it's a little...
Let's go inside!
Hello?
You know what? I want to live there.
So Luigi goes and investigates, only to be attacked by the ghost of an orange condom until... So this guy's Professor E. Gadd.
Get it? E. Gadd.
So the professor has a machine called the Poltergust 3000, which can capture ghosts. So Luigi plans to use it to get Mario back and stop all those haunted ghosts in his house.
Were you expecting something else?
Alright, now that I'm suited up, let's fight some damn ghosts.
Toad!
So Toad's in the game too, and guess what? He plays a role in the game. He'll occasionally update you on minor story stuff, and he'll save your game. Another odd tool in Luigi's arsenal is a very complex Game Boy Color that goes by the name Game Boy Horror. So the Game Boy Horror has a map, a phone to EGAD, and gives you information on some things that you take a picture of.
Say, what's this thing got on Luigi?
So there are a lot of different enemies in this game. Slap Happy Orange Ghost, Pink
Falcon Punch
Ghosts, and even Banana Ghosts. Classic. And then there's much larger ghosts, which I guess are mini-bosses. However, I've never seen mini-bosses like this before. You see, if you just try to run up to them, they'll disappear.
Coward!
See, unlike all the little ghosts, these ghosts have hearts.
Oh, memory.
And in order to get them to show their heart,
oh,
you need to do or wait for different things. Dredix, it isn't working. Let me just test it for a few more seconds.
Dredix, it's a ghost!
Where the hell is Psycho? Also, sucking them up is outstandingly funny.
Holy shit, fucking hell, oh my lord! What am I doing right now? Swimming! I'm swimming! Look at me go!
Oh, it's one of those games. Just good music all around.
And I think the best part is how it just connects the game together. Like when you first enter the house, there's no music. Then, when you enter the parlor for the first time, the tension builds until...
The ghost is coming to get you, and the music's coming to get you too, so it looks like you have a lot of problems on your hands!
Oh, so you want me to fight a baby ghost?
Bring it on!
I'm sorry. Are you sleeping? Are you really sleeping? Are you ignoring me?
Don't make me break my foot off in your ass!
Well, I can't just wake up the baby. And there's a bunch of coins surrounding that toy horse.
Did you taste that? Ugh, tastes like conveyance.
Hey there, baby. You wanna play ball?
Yeah, I hit a baby. Who's the badass?
Me.
I take it back. Demon baby! Demon baby! Demon baby! Demon baby!
Now to go back to EGAD's place. Oh, wait, but first...
Love it.
Now then, to finally see what EGAD even needs these ghosts for. Okay. Going into a... washing machine. And are they one ghost now? And why the hell do you need to do that? And what? That's weird. You're weird. Oh, EGAD. EGAD. You monster. They're already dead.
Thank.
Okay. So that was like going into a meat factory.
It's really fucked up been weird!
Okay, so I got the boss key, but the door that it opens is covered in thorns!
Oi! Thorns?!
So how the hell am I supposed to open a door covered with thorns?
What the fuck?
So it's really cool how the game takes place entirely in a mansion, because the level design still does feel large and varied. Also, if you revisit an already beaten area, you'll notice that all the lights are on, and there's no more haunting music.
Sorry, I'm just drinking in all this atmosphere.
Damn it, I really want to go into that broom closet, but I have to fight all these shy guys.
Could someone back up the wambulance? I need a ride.
Okay, now let me in that damn broom closet. Okay, whatever. Do your little dance. I'm just waiting for the hearts.
Okay, now for that goddamn broom closet.
Taco Pants!
Worth it!
Ugh. Hey, look, a button. What does that say? Do not pre-click.
Son of a bitch!
Well, way to go, Bobby Button Bopper. We just let out the most annoying race of ghosts out there because you wanted to see a broom closet. So the boos become another enemy in the game, but they prefer to hide in the more lit room. Meaning, once you've defeated all the ghosts and you've lit up the room and gotten the key and are ready to move on,
it's still not fucking over!
Instead, you have to go play tag with a cackling boo that really loves to jump between rooms.
Get over here, goddammit!
Oh. Hey, you!
Coming for you, you piece of poltergeist!
Oh. Gotta go take the stupid stairs to go to a room on the same floor. Oh, come on, where is he?
There was a lot of dirty underwear in there.
I didn't need to know that! Back here, you little... Oh, a mouse hole. Let's take a picture of it. Now that I'm rich, I think I'll delve into the magical world of music. Now, how do you play one of these things?
A brilliant piece of work. Give me back my pipe. Mario. Give it.
You know, I love music. Music is the best. And who the hell are you?
Hey, that's Mario music. Water level, right? Oh my god.
Despite everyone's usual complaint about Luigi's Mansion, how it's nothing like a Mario game, it definitely doesn't lose its Mario feel. There's still mushrooms, except they suck. You still collect coins and pick up keys. There's iconic music, memorable enemies, and a powerful atmosphere.
And also, would you be insinuating that Luigi's Mansion needs to be more like... Because that would be really fucking boring!
Also, that would completely eliminate the point of Super Mario Bros. 64, Mario Kart, Super Mario Bros. 2, Super Mario RPG, Paper Mario, Mario & Luigi, Superstar's Dog, and Super Mario Sunshine-
No, wait! Super Mario Sunshine sucked, right? Because it was different, not the same game for 25 years! Don't you dare say Legend of Zelda!
Alright. Got a little sidetracked there. So... what I missed? So, there's a fat ghost who shoots fireballs at you.
Hard burn.
You defeat a ghost dog by giving it a ghost bone.
How the hell does that even work?
And finally come to the second boss, who...
legitimately scary boss.
Shit, what do I got? I got a fucking vacuum. How do I...
So you defeat him by merging his shadow with himself. Deep. Whoop, got them all. Now to watch them suffer again.
That's horrifying.
Now for the Boo level. Goddamn Boo level.
Boo just suck. I mean, they just suck.
They're annoying, they cackle, they're hard to get, but it's kind of made up for it when you finally do catch them. The challenge is nice, so the rewarding feels better. Luigi does a funny little dance, and you're able to save the game immediately afterwards.
So that way, if like the console shuts down, you don't lose like 10 ghosts, let alone one.
So now I'm walking around a garden level with adorable little pink ghosts that just want to fly around and have fun. And oh god, they hurt you, but they're still adorable! Hey, I think I hear something down in that well. What is this? Oh my god! God, that must have been so painful. I've seen how that works. The best part about this is that you're able to come back to this point anytime. And no, not in like a creepy, ha ha, you're trapped in a painting and I'm not kind of thing. It's more like you're able to get this close to Mario, but you just can't reach him. You can even see the final boss sitting right fucking there! It's like any time that you ever need support, you just come down to the well, you look through the lion head, and BAM! You're incented. The game now wants me to fight two little boys!
Bring. It. On!
I am on fire right now! I could take down this whole house right now! Who's next? Shy Guys? Booze? Observe the... Toys?
I believe!
I feel great! I saw Buddha! I am ready for this boss! It's just a boo, so come on! Come on, boss! Bring it on!
I don't think I'm ready anymore!
This boss is... All you gotta do is just suck up the big boo and then pop him into a bunch of little boos. But you can't suck up the little boos, you have to freeze them first. And they are the most erratic, cackling little creatures I've ever had to endure! Get over here, you're gonna die, just get on with it, get over here, shut up, little man!
Oh, yeah!
And now, my favorite part.
Try to run away from that! Shut up, Globox! Light? Light.
Who are you?
I am Henry Picklebottom.
You wouldn't happen to know where the key to the power room is, do you?
Oh, yes, I have that key in my pocket right here.
Oh my goodness!
Might makes light!
So, the last remaining level takes place in both the attic and the basement. Man, I really want to get to the roof, but I don't know how. Oh, I know, I can ask the bullshit soldiers. It's so tranquil on the roof. So serene. So peaceful. Oh, look. A fire. On my roof!
Oh my god, a fire! Blow it out! 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 No! Fuck just makes more!
I'm kind of losing it over here, so how about I sum up the rest of the game before I reach Tron times?
So Luigi has to capture King Boo, but you can't get him unless you get all the Boos. And get all the keys to all the doors and turn on all the lights.
So now that I'm here, let's fight King Boo.
There must be something great about King Boo. I mean, he's the king, so he must have like 1,000 health or laser feet, or he's got a giant Bowser doll with a detachable floating head that shoots ice and throws balls.
Huh. I guess King Boo just really wanted to be in Bowser.
Thank you. You're all great. You're a wonderful audience. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. No, thank you, dude. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
Oh, so you think that you're funny, no? Well, say hello to my Poltergeist 3000, copyright 2012!
Oh, fuck. So all you have to do is suck up his balls and shoot them into his mouth when he starts sucking.
Alright, there's the king. I've got plans for you, you sack of ooze. Oh.
This is for every goddamn motherfucking shit-sucking, skin-peeling, ass-melting, government-crushing, hound-verbing, monkey-chucking boo that I had to get to this point! You suck, right?
So, you've stopped King Boo and you've gotten Mario back. So a good day all around, and a great game all around.
This was the launch title of the GameCube, and the first GameCube game I ever played.
People often accuse this game of being way too different from the original Mario formula, and I'm not saying that games are only good when they're constantly changing. I mean, we have an entire CDI trilogy to explain why that makes no sense. But people really need to come into this game with a different mindset, because it's not a Mario game. Hell, Mario wasn't even in it. He was stuck in the painting, and I guess he's still stuck in the painting.
Huh. How do you get him out? Good day, complete strangers. The name is Dradix, and I'm an expert.